Our next topic will be about the limits. So what is a limit? It says here, a limit is the value that a function or sequence approaches as the input or index approaches some value. So mamaya, malalaman natin kung ano talaga yung definition ng limit natin. Let the function of x be a function of x and let a be constant if there is a number l such that in order to make the value of the function of x as close to L as may be desired, it is sufficient to choose x close enough to A but different from A. Then we say that the limit of function of x as x approaches A is L. So mahabang definition ito, but we can make a shortcut out of it by writing the limit of the function of x as x approaches to A is equal to L. Okay? Sometimes we can work something out directly, but we can see what it should be as we get closer and closer. So for example, function of x is equal to x squared minus 1 over x minus 1. Okay, so what if we are going to give a certain value for x, which is 1? Okay, papalitan natin ng 1 yung ating x. So the function of 1 is equal to 1 squared minus 1 over 1 minus 1. So that will result to 0 over 0, which is considered indeterminate, or we don't know the exact answer for this. So instead of trying to work it out for x is equal to 1, let's try approaching it closer and closer. So for the same function of x, okay, gagawa tayo ng table, gagawa natin ng certain values yung ating x na approaching 1. Okay, so 0.5, that is equal to 1.5. Kung isa-substitute ko yung 0.5 sa aking function as x, okay, that will result to 1.5. Yung 0.9 ko, that is 1.9, and so on for 0.99999, that results to 1.99999. Okay? But, kung isa-substitute ko naman yung 1 dito, which is obviously kasunod ng 0.99999, yung result niya is indeterminate, but we can see that the value is approaching to the value of 2. Okay, when x is equal to 1, we don't know the answer. It is indeterminate, but we can see that it is going to be 2. Based sa ating table, makikita natin that it is going to be 2. But when we are going to substitute 1 to our x in our equation, that is indeterminate. So that is mainly the concept of a limit. We want to give the answer to but can't. So instead, mathematicians say exactly by using the special word limit. Okay? So the limit of the function of x as x approaches 1 is 2, or it is written as like that. Or the limit of x squared minus 1 over x minus 1 as x approaches to 1 is equal to 2. Okay, so there are some theorems on limits. The first one, the limit of a sum of two functions is the sum of the limits. So for example, may dalawang functions ako. Within a bracket of limit, okay, pwede ko siyang isubstitute yung limit ko sa dalawang functions, which will be equal to limit of the function of x plus limit of g of x. The second one, difference naman. Okay, so the same concept, pinalitan ko lang yung sign ko dito sa, from plus, naging minus na siya. So, pwede ko ding i-distribute yung limit sign ko. The same sa product, pwede din siya. And sa quotient, kung may function of x divided by gx ako within a certain limit symbol, pwede kong i-substitute to the numerator and to the denominator yung aking limit. Okay? The fifth one, the limit of a function with a constant k is equal to the product of the constant k and the function. So for example, may isa akong constant k under sa symbol ko na limit, pwede ko siyang palabasin sa aking limit symbol. Okay, as long as constant siya and it does not belong to the function of x. Okay lang siya. Then the sixth theorem, the limit of 1 over x minus a as x approaches to a is infinity. Then, the seventh one, The limit of 1 over x minus a as x approaches infinity is equal to 0. The limit of sine a over a as a approaches 0 is equal to 1. Then the last is the limit of 1 minus cosine a over a as a approaches 0 is equal to 0. Okay, so for examples, our first set of example, we have to evaluate the limits of the following. So the first one, the limit of x squared plus 3x minus 5 as x approaches 2, 4. So here, we can apply the concept of functions kung i-check natin that the answer is not indeterminate. Okay? So substitute natin yung 4 sa ating x. So that is 4 squared plus 3 times 4 minus 5. 4 squared is 16, 3 times 4 is 12 minus 5. Then that results to 23. So the limit of x squared plus 3x minus 5 as x approaches to 4 is equal to 23. The second one, the limit of 2x squared plus x plus 4 as x approaches negative 1. So the same process. So 2 times negative 1 squared plus negative 1 plus 4. 2 minus 1 plus 4, 2 na lang kasi negative 1 squared is positive 1. Positive 1 times 2 is 2. Plus negative 1, positive times negative is negative, then plus 4. So 2 minus 1 plus 4 is equal to 5. The next one, the limit of t plus 1 squared over 2 times t squared plus 3 as t approaches 1. Okay, substitute natin kung hindi indeterminate yung ating makukuhang sagot. Okay, so 1 plus 1 squared over 2 times 1 squared plus 3. So 1 plus 1 is of course 2 squared over 2 times 4 since 1 squared is 1 plus 3 is 4. Simplify, 2 squared is 4, 2 times 4 is 8. Or simplifying the fraction, that is equal to 1/2. Okay?